Hey everyone! In this episode of ITS Now, we'll be looking at the history of traffic signals, which go back a lot further than most people realise. We're doing this because it really is where intelligent transport systems comes from. I'm Alistair, and this is ITS Now. A lot of people are surprised to find out that the history of traffic signalisation predates the advent of motorised vehicles. The technologies that lie at the root of this actually emanate from research work undertaken by the British Admiralty in two particular fields. Communication. To enable the Admiralty in London to communicate quickly with the naval ports along the south coast of England, a chain of optical telegraph stations were erected in the late 18th century. The operation of the telegraph was further improved by work undertaken by General Pasley in the early 19th century, who observed the system perfected in France by Claude Sharp, which resulted in the adoption of the semaphore style of telegraph from 1816 in the UK. In later life, General Pasley became the Inspector General of Railways, and during this time, in response to rising accident rates, suggested the use of the semaphore signal as a means of improving communication with locomotive drivers. The first of these was erected by Charles Gregory of the London and Croydon Railway at New Cross in 1841. Navigation. With the introduction of steamships in the mid-19th century, there was a huge increase in collisions at sea, resulting in many ships being lost. Following the work of a parliamentary select committee which first looked at the issue in 1831, a number of studies were carried out. These included investigating the use of coloured lights to make the direction a ship is travelling in more apparent to other vessels in poor visibility and in the dark. It was found that oil lamps with clear, red and green lenses could be viewed from the greatest distance with a minimum risk of misinterpretation. The outcome of this study was the recommendation that red and green lights should be used as navigation sidelights on vessels, which were adopted universally in 1858. These two bodies of work, which were leading edge technologies at the time, resulted in two sets of developments. The widespread adoption of semaphore signals to control traffic on the railways, and the use of red and green lights as visual warning signals. In the mid-19th century, traffic congestion in London was getting worse. And in response to a suggestion made by a parliamentary select committee, the first traffic signal in the world was installed in Bridge Street, adjacent to the Houses of Parliament, in December 1868. This was undertaken to enable MPs to cross over the busy street. The signal, which was promoted by railway engineer J.P. Knight, who lived nearby in Bridge Street, was over 20 foot high. When the semaphore arm was extended horizontally, it meant stop, and when lowered to 45 degrees, it meant proceed with caution. At the top of the pole were red and green gas lights, which were used to augment the arm at night. The operation of the signals was controlled manually by a police officer using a handle. Unfortunately, the signal didn't last for long, because on the 2nd of January 1869, leaking gas in the signal caused it to explode. The police operator was injured in the incident, resulting in the installation being removed. Today, a memorial plaque commemorates John Peak Knight, close to where the signal was installed in Bridge Street, opposite the Palace of Westminster, in the shadow of the Elizabeth Tower and Big Ben. After this, the only other recorded traffic signal installation in the UK was part of the bridge interlocking system, which controlled the lifting operation at Tower Bridge. The system was designed and manufactured by the railway signal firm of Saxby and Farmer, who had also made the earlier signal at Bridge Street. Included in the system were semaphore signals, also fitted with green and red gas lights, for both river and highway traffic, which worked in relation to the operation of the bridge. Part of the mounting bracket for the original signal is still visible today. Since opening in June 1894, the traffic signals have continued to control traffic flow on the bridge, which arguably makes Tower Bridge the oldest signalised location in the world. No further attempts seem to have been made at mechanised traffic control until the growth of motorised traffic in the US led to a need to control junctions in the early 20th century. A plethora of different signal systems were developed over the coming years, but these mainly fell into two families: semaphore arms and light signals. One of the most famous of the semaphore type of signals was patented in 1922 by inventor Garrett Morgan. His signal consisted of rotating arms, red and green lights, and a bell, which warned of an impending change. Although this system was hand-cranked, it had the added sophistication of including an all-stop period between opposing traffic streams, which allowed pedestrians to cross the road and the junction to clear. However, it soon became apparent that semaphore styles of signals were an evolutionary dead end. The first electric light was invented by Lester Farnsworth Wire and installed in Salt Lake City in 1912. Lester was the head of the traffic division of the Salt Lake City Police Department. His signal had two lamps, one red and one green, and was installed in a large wooden box with two six-inch holes on each side. It was operated by a patrolman who used a two-way switch to change the light's colours. However, in this instance, the same signal was displayed to all approaches. The colour it illuminated, red or green, signified traffic could flow on a particular approach. William Potts, a Detroit policeman, invented the first three-colour lights in 1920. His four-way signal head used railway signal lamps and was designed to be suspended over the centre of a junction to control traffic from four approaches. It was the first signal to resemble the operation we know today. In 1924, the first electric traffic signals in Europe were installed on a five-sided police tower in the very busy Potsdamer Platz in Berlin. The five sets of lights around the top of the tower faced the approaching streets and were manually controlled by the police operator. A replica of the tower was erected in September 2000 after the original was removed in 1936. In England, the first manually controlled electric traffic lights were installed in Piccadilly, London, in 1925, and the first automatically controlled signals were installed in Prince's Square, Wolverhampton, in 1927. Today, this junction has specially painted black and white signal poles to commemorate its historic significance. During the 1930s, experiments were carried out in the use of vehicle actuation to make traffic signals responsive to vehicles using a junction. An early attempt at this utilised a microphone placed at the side of the road, which would make the lights respond to motorists sounding their horns. Although this system worked, it was very unpopular with people living nearby. Later experiments used electrical pressure mats and pneumatic tubes. These were extensively used up to the 1970s when they were replaced with inductive loops for permanent installations, although they are still used for temporary count sites where they are fitted to the surface of the carriageway. This is the remnants of a tube detector next to your current day inductive loop that I noticed in Guildford, UK. The first vehicle actuated site in the UK was installed in 1932 at Grace Church Street and Cornhill in London. Unfortunately, history repeated the events of 1869 when the controller blew up. In this case, though, gas had seeped into the controller cabinet through the underground cable ducts from a nearby leaking gas main and was sparked by the electrical apparatus in the controller. The good news is, on this occasion, the accident did not block the course of progress, and within a couple of years, vehicle-actuated controllers were being used widely across the country. There are still surprising remnants of 1930s equipment still around, like this ATE Electromatic Type 37 cabinet on the corner of Queen Victoria Street and Friday Street in London, and this even rare example of a working ATE signals at Carisbrook Castle on the Isle of Wight. Modern traffic signals make use of an ever-increasing range of technologies, which we will go on to look at in future episodes. Thanks for watching. I'd also like to take the opportunity to thank those of you who have been in contact to explore how we might work together on future episodes. We have some exciting developments which I'll be able to let you know about soon. But if you have any suggestions for topics or products which you'd like us to look at on the series, then please get in contact. If you're not already, please feel free to connect to me on LinkedIn to keep updated with news. And have a look at the itsnow.org website. See you next time.